Welcome to reality. For the first Met Gala we did it with a star tracker with stars on the ground. So for those shows, a live preview is really important. So we actually take two engines. Even though we're only using one engine, we bring a second engine in a PTZ, a UE150 Panasonic, so we can see and set up the graphics and do scale and color and brightness, you know, contrast, and make sure the white and black levels are good. And so we do use two engines, one to set offsets and position, and the other one's the live CG. We have a team cutting them out in Photoshop, grabbing up producers, curating the content and finding and knowing which dress. That also goes to the EPs who might say, I don't want Ariana DeBose for some reason. But no, let's say they always want Ariana DeBose. But maybe if it's some celebrity they really want, and that's the one that they're gonna be talking about next segment. So we have to have that one loaded and properly cut out. We have to make sure that all the cutouts are nice, especially around the earrings and detail pieces. And then it's already integrated on the other engine, so we can just give them, the producers, a quick, yes, it's ready. And then they can go to it. The show is about 4 hours long for the red carpet segment. And then no cameras are allowed inside, I don't think. So yeah, we're just on the outside. We have teams doing interviews, but we actually pull the Met Gala, the Getty images from the wall of photographers that are shooting photos. One of the tricky parts is a lot of times the photographers are lighting differently or will have different color balances. And then we're having to tweak to try to match the set environment, especially with our white levels and, you know, so it can get a little tricky, but it's a lot of fun. Our team consists of three people. One person's dealing with tracking and making sure all the tracking is working properly, which also lays on me because I have to make sure that, you know, the tracking's coming in properly to zero density, our positions are right, our axes are crop proper. And then we have an operator who plays the graphics out, because that's its own nutshell. If you have advanced graphics on a dime, you don't want the director yelling at you. So we have a proper graphics operator to know that what we're setting up and practicing and rehearsing with on our stage, we can easily export and put on their stage with their equipment. Because we're two different locations, we need to make sure all the graphics look proper, all the colors, because they're very particular about their colors, and we need to make sure that they look good, and zero density helps us through the workflow of the R-Graph and layout and Action Builder. We can make sure that what we see in our studio is what they're going to see on theirs. And it makes it a very easy transition when we're updating a project or we're loading a totally new project. And having the iterative cook process really helps us know that it's gonna launch and work properly without dropping frames. And if we do mess something up, we can always just go back. And that's one of the beauties of it.